कृतारि वञ्चने दृष्टिः येनाञ्जनमलीमसा अच्युताय नमस्तस्मै परमौचित्यकारिणि. So the Navarasas, the auchityam and anauchityam in the Navarasas we saw, the rasas need not exist separately. They can also exist along with each other. And the way they have to exist with each other is very important. Where Jnyeyam Shrungara Bibatsau Tatha Veera Bayanakau Raudra Adbhutau Tatha Hasya Karunau Vairinau Mitaha. Two rasas are actually considered as vairi or enemies. The list that Nati Shastra gives is Shringara and Bibatsa are supposed to be Virodhi Rasa, Veera and Bhayanaka, Raudra and Adbhuta, Hasya and Karuna. These are vairi rasas because you can't experience both together at the same time. In that, even when you employ Virodhi Rasa together in one shloka or in a context, in a kavyam, it depends on how the kavi uses that rasa to portray a propriety in his expression. So rasa sankaram is a big topic both in Dhvanyalokam and to a small extent in Kavya Prakasham, but Dhvanyaloka he deals with it in a more elaborate sense. So here also he takes up a few examples. So the first example he talks of is Shantarasam and Shringaram. And then he also shows Shringara Bibatsa Yoho, how the two rasas can exist mutually in a very appropriate manner. So Rasa Sankara Auchityam, the first, when he starts off the topic, he gives a pithika for that. यथा मधुरतिक्ताद्याः रसाः कुशलयोजिताः विचित्राः विचित्र आस्वादतां यान्ति शृङ्गाराद्याः तथा मिथः तेषां परस्पराश्लेषात् कुर्याद् औचित्यरक्षणम् अनौचित्येन संस्पृष्टः कस्य इष्टः रससङ्करः. एक्चुअली इवन् इन् ध्वन्यालोक हि टाक्स् अबौट् दिस् इन् बिग् मेनर् यु विल् रीड् अबौट् इट् लेटर्. So rasa sankaraha, 1 minute, let me get my book. Yatha madhura tiktadyaha rasaha kushala yojitaha. Kushala yojitaha, just as how the different rasas in cooking, there are many different rasas like katu, madhura, amla, lavanadyaha. Kushala sudena, kushala yojitaha means sudaha is a cook. A very expert cook can beautifully mix both katu. Katu is bitter, madhuram sweet, amlam is tangy or sour, and lavana is salt. You can mix all of these in the appropriate portion. And vichitra aswadatam yanti, these rasas, just like how in cooking you mix so many different rasas, and there is a unique different taste that arises. Aswadatam, a taste arises, it attains a very different taste. Tatha shringaradyaha api mithaha. Why is it like this? Okay, so shringaradyaha api, shringara etc., other rasas also attain a very unique vichitra aswadatam yanti. You have to take that vichitra aswadatam yanti for both kushala yojitaha madhura tiktadyaha and for this. Madhuram, tiktam is tangy. So, shringaradyaha rasaha api yatha mithaha parasparam vichitra aswadatam yanti. So, tesham paraspara asleshat, by mixing them together, auchitya rakshanam kuryat, when they both are mixed together, auchitya rakshanam kuryat, the propriety has to be protected when you are mixing them together. Anauchityena samsrishtaha rasasankaraha kasya ishtaha bhavati. So when the rasa sankara, a mix of rasa, is samsprishtaha, is touched by anauchityam, kasya ishtaha bhavati? Who would want to even, you know, read such a shloka where the mix of those rasas is not proper? Vritti he gives, इस रसाः कटु मधुर आम्ल लवणाद्याः कुशलसूदेन बै एन एक्सपर्ट् कुक् वेसवार पानादिषु योजिताः. वेसवार इस् टैप् आफ् पानगम्. You know, for Ramanavami, you make that panagam, that is called Vesavara. It is made by ginger, dhaniya, etc. So, something very similar to panagam. Some people say it could also be the, you know, the Marathi amti that they make, which is very similar to sambar. So, in other words, it has all these katu, madhura, amla and lavana brasaha, tatra militaha, yojitaha, vichitra aswadatama upayanti, tathaiva parasparam, aviruddhaha, shungaradaya. He specifies aviruddhaha. Tesham anyonyam angabhava yojanayam. Anyonyam angabhava yojanayam, you have to mix them in such a manner that one is secondary, the other is primary. With a dependency, anga bhava yojana is a dependency should be there between these rasas, and that is when auchityasya jivita sarvabhutasya, jivita sarvabhutasya kavyasya jivita sarvabhutasya kavyasya atma iva vartati. Not, he doesn't use the word atma here anywhere because he is a dhvanikara in essence. He believes that dhvani is the atma. But auchityam is the jivitva sarvasvabhutam. It is the essence of even that atma. So that auchityam is absolutely necessary, which is the jivitva sarvasvabhutam, tasya raksham kuryat. Anauchitya rajasa, rasa samyogaha sprishtaha, na kasyachit abhimataha ityartaha. Rasa samyogaha, the mix of rasa, rasa sankara, which is touched by sprishtaha, anauchitya rajasa, even by a dust, or even by a little bit of anauchityam, then it is not kasyachit na abhimatam bhavati. Next is, so he gives an examples for this rasa sankaram. He gives three or four examples. One is Shanta Shungaram, the other is Veera Karunam. Next, I think he takes up Shanta Shungara Karuna Vibhatsa, four rasas together. And then he goes to Anauchityam, for which he gives two examples. So, if possible, we'll look at these three today. Just the Auchityam, Anauchityam we'll take up next week. Rasa Sankaryam. Rasa Sankara Auchitye Shanta Shungara Yoho Angangi Bhavaha Yatha Bhagavataha Maharshehe Vyasasya. So Angangi Bhavam is absolutely important. So you have to first determine which is the Angi. Angi is the Pradhanam. What is the Pradhana Rasa in the context, in the Prakaranam? Then you will have to look at the other rasa and to ensure that it stays as the angabhutam or the secondary in that shlokam. Here this is Vyasa shloka. Satyam manorama ramaha satyam ramya vibhutayaha kintu matta angana apanga bhangi lolam hi jivitam. Pradhanam here, the angirasam is shantarasam. Satyam ramaha manoramaha. It's true that the ladies are beautiful. Wealth is also beautiful. Ramyaha vibhutayaha. Vibhutayaha sampattihi. So sampattayaha api ramyaha eva vartante. Satyam. I accept that. Kintu. But, you know, this life, jivitam hi, bhangi lolam. It is very lolam. It is very momentary. And it is momentary. At the same time, it's got the beauty of a lady's apanga. Matta angana apanga iva bhangi sundaram tadha lolam cha asti jivitam. Matta angana, a girl, a lady who is intoxicated, and her corner of the eye, when she's already a beautiful lady, her the apangam will be very beautiful. But if she is intoxicated, then it is chanchalam. It's not steadfast at one point. So it is both chanchalam and beautiful. So matta angana apanga bhangi lolam jivitam. This life is very momentary and fleeting like that apanga of a lady. So Without Madhira, her Apangam will be very fixed on the lover, and she will express her ideas even more easier. Sthiratvam. Whereas because it is Mattam, it is Lolam. Atra Bhagavata Jantuhita Abhinivishtena Mokshakshama Upadeshe. So the Pradhana Rasam here is Shantarasam. He wants to portray, Vyasa wants to tell people that, you know, this Jivitam Moksha Pradhanam Asti. Whatever I am trying to say, you have to take it as Moksha Pradhanam, and in this Jivitam, you should work towards Moksha. So Jantuhita Abhinivishtena Bhagavata, it is as an adjective to Vyasena. So Vyasa has in his mind Jantuhitam. He has the good benefit. He feels that whatever he has to say has to be beneficial to the people. So Jantuhitam eva manasi vartate tena karanat. So moksha krama upadeshe asmin. He's talking that you have to work towards moksha. Anginaha shantarasasya. Angirasam is Chantarasa, so because he says, I accept Satyam Manorama Rama. There is Shringaram. Satyam Ramya Vibhutayaha, the sampatti that you want, the wealth that you're looking for in this world is also beautiful and attractive. So there you see the Shringaram there. But he ends with the Angirasam, which is the Chantarasam, by saying Jivitam Lolam. So Sakala Mana Jana Mana Prakhladane. You can't just directly tell people like how you know in Vairagya Shatakam, it's a very bitter pill that he says. Yeah. Huh? I didn't understand, it didn't come out properly in the question. Okay. So Anya sakala jana manah prakladane bala guda jihvikaya shringare angabhavam upanite sati. If you're trying to say some hita vakyam to someone, like in Vairagya Shatakam, he says, adena vyaghrivatishtati jara paritarjayanti. See, the jara, old age, is just standing like a female tiger waiting to pounce on you. Rogascha shatravaiva praharanti deham, just like enemies who keep on attacking and try to find loopholes. Diseases are just waiting to attack your body. They're constantly attacking your body. Ayuh parisravati bhinna ghatadivambaha. The ghatam is not completely broken. Imagine your life is like a pot full of water, and there is just one crack, and your ayus, your jivitam is slowly flowing out of that pot. That's how your life is flowing out. It's every step, you know, they say every step towards the grave. You know, there is something similar to that. So Ayuh parisravati bhinna ghatavativa ambaha, not completely destroyed, nashta ghatavativa. So it is bhinna ghatavativa ambaha, tathapi ahitamacharati iti chitram, lokas tathapi ahitamacharati iti chitram. It's very ascharyam that people are still performing ahitam, bad, you know, hurting others. This is, so that is the idea that he wants to say, but not in such a harsh manner. Vyasa adopts a very beautiful, like sugar coating a pill, a bitter pill, and he says, Satyam Manorama Rama Kintu Lolam Jivita. Imagine this will have a much better effect. No, I accept what in what state you are. I accept that it is difficult to let go of those attractions that are there in the world. Yet, think of it like this. Then it'll immediately get into the brain. So Bala Guda Jihvikaya, if you want to do Karnavedanam for a baby, you will give sugar in the mouth and then quickly do that. It's a painful process, but somehow you have to get it done. At the same time, you try to give something sweet for the child. Tadvat. So Bala Gudam is jaggery. By putting the jaggery underneath the tongue, jihva, for a child, in that manner, you are putting that shringaram. Shringare angabhavam upanite sati. Paryante shantasyaiva. At the end, it is only shanta that he is trying to highlight by saying lolam jivitam. Iti anityata pratipadanam. showing the effervescent nature of life. It is very momentary, and it can you don't know what is going to happen tomorrow or even today. After you will be planning so many things, some 4 classes, 5 classes, but you don't know what is going to happen, and suddenly something will come up, and you're going to, you know, that is the effervescent nature of life. Anityada Pratipadana Parinirvaheena, by showing the anityata, by showing that it is anityam, an extreme propriety has been made. So Parama Auchityam Uchaihi Kritam. He has highlighted, Uchaih Kritam means he has established or highlighted that it is a Parama Auchityam for employing both Shringaram and Shantarasam in this. And keeping the Shantarasam as the Angirasa and never losing its Pradhanatvam in the Shloka. You should look at Dhvanyalokam, where Lochanakara explained this in a more beautiful manner. Next is, so in this we saw the Shantarasam and Shringaram. The next is Bibhatsa Shringara Yoho Auchitya. Yeah. Any questions? Yeah, no, it's a beautiful shlokam. Vyasa has written this, right? So Bibhatsa Shringara Yoho Auchityam, Bibhatsa Shringara Yoho Angangi Bhavaha Yatha Mama Bauddha Avadana Kalpalatayam. Kshemendra has written this Bauddhavadana Kalpalata, where it is a Shantarasa Pradhanam. So because of Shantam, he wants to highlight the you know, the disgust that is there in the world. He wants to show people how, using Bibhatsan, he wants to take people towards that Shantarasam. There is only this world is filled with so many disgusting things, right? He takes an example, many examples from this Bauddhavadana Kalpatata. The example he gives here is Kshibasya Iva Achalasya Druta Hrita Hridaya Jambuki Kantasakta Raktabhivyaktakama Kamati Nakha Mukha Ullekha उल्लेखम् आसूत्रयन्ति आस्वाद्यास्वाद्ययोनः क्षणमधरदलं दत्तदन्तव्रणाङ्कं लग्नानङ्गक्रियायाम् इयम् अतिरभस उत्कर्षम् आविष्करोति इयं जम्बुकी रति सॉरी अनङ्गक्रियायां लग्न अनङ्गक्रियायाम् इयं जम्बुकी अतिरभस उत्कर्षम् आविष्करोति. मेन् सेण्टेन्स् हियर् इस् यूनः अधरदलम् आस्वाद्य आस्वाद्य यूनः. There is a shavam, a dead body of a yuva. The young person's dead body is there. It is unmoving. Achalasya yunaha is unmoving, so you know that it is a shavam. And then kshibasya iva. It is as if someone who is intoxicated and he is just lying on the ground without, he is unconscious. Okay? It is as if an intoxicated person who is unconscious. In the same manner, this yuva, his body is also achalaha. That is also unmoving, as if intoxicated. Now, this jambuki, further, that is also, the rest are all jambuki adjectives for the jambuki. So, ananga kriyayam, let's look at the jambuki vyavaharam, a female fox, a jackal, how she is behaving with that corpse. There is this yuvakasya shavaha asti and yunaha adharadalam. She keeps pulling at the corpse there. Adharam, the lips. So how is the jambuki? Druta hrita hridaya. Drutam, quickly. Hrita hridaya, she has plucked out the hridayam from the corpse. Okay? Drutam hritam hridayam vyayasa. For what has she plucked out the hridayam? To eat, naturally. So that itself, the first itself has given us that Bibhatsa rasam is very clear. Now let me highlight the Shringara rasam also continuously so that it's easier to understand. Usually I try to go with one paksham and then go with the other paksham, whereas here I would like to show the contrast side by side. So Druta Hrita Hridaya in a Nayika, imagine a Nayika who is wanting to do this Ananga Kriya. मन्मथक्रीडायां सा कथं भवति द्रुतहृतहृदया, द्रुतं क्विक्लि शीघ्रं सौन्दर्येण तस्याः हृदयं हृतम् आकर्षितं भवति. सो शी इस् अट्राक्टेड् टुवर्ड्स् दिस् पर्सन् क्विक्लि एस् सून् एस् शी लुक्स् एट् हिम् द युवकं जम्बुकि. So that is only the Jambuki is the Shije call. Next is Kantasakta. She is also Kanthe Lagna. Two ideas that corpse is there. This Shije call has caught hold of that neck there. Next is she, after plucking out the Hridayam, she goes and catches the neck. So here the Naika, she is attracted to the form and she goes in Alingdanam Karoti. Kanthe Alingdati. Embraces him at the neck. रक्त अभिव्यक्त काम. वाट् इस् द जम्बुकी डु? रक्ते सा स्वकामं प्रदर्शयति. अभिव्यक्त काम रक्ते रुधिरे. शी वाण्ट्स् दट् ब्लड्. शी जेकाल् वाण्ट्स् टु टेस्ट् दट् ब्लड् दट् इस् देयर् फ्रोम् दट् कार्प्स्. वेर् इस् हियर् अनुरक्ता स्वकामं च स्वमन्मथ विकारं च अभिव्यक्ता व्यञ्जयति. She shows off her, because she is attracted, she immediately shows that she is attracted. She is highlighting it in her behavior. That how bow that we say, through anubhavam, etc., kataksha vikshetam, and all that. So, rakta abhivyakta kama, the nayika shows her interest towards this nayaka. Nakham mukha ullekham asutrayanti. नखमुख उल्लेखम् आसूत्रयन्ति कमति. आसूत्रयन्ति कमति. कमति शी इस् ब्यूटिफुल् बै शोयिङ्ग् नखमुख क्षतम् उल्लेखम्. आसूत्रयन्ति इस् उल्लेखयति. शी नख ऐ थिङ्क् शी शोयिङ्ग् आफ् दट् नेल् मार्क्स् एण्ड् आल् मेकिङ्ग् नेल् मार्क्स् एण्ड् बैट् मार्क्स्. ओके, सो नखमुख उल्लेखम् नखैः मुखैः च उल्लेखं करोति. और् आसूत्रयति मीन्स् करोति देर् फोर् द जम्बुकि. ऐ फोगाट् टु डु देट्. नखमुख उल्लेखयोः सूत्र आकारेण मांसं लग्नं. सो वाट् एवर् शी हेस् ट्रैड् टु पुल् देट् हार्ट् औट्, शी इस् केचिङ्ग् होल्ड् आफ् द नेक् आफ् देट् कार्प्स्. आल् देट् इस् जस्ट् हेङ्गिङ्ग् फ्रम् हर् मौत् एण्ड् हर् नेल्स्. The she jackal. So like a sutram, like a thread, it is hanging from her nails and mukham. And she is kamati prakashate. She is also showing off that she has tasted that corpse. Yunaha kshanam adhara dalam datta danta varana ankam. Datta dana, all these are all, next is only kriya visheshana. So adhara dalam दत्त दन्त व्रणाङ्कम्. दीस् टु आर् फार् दि अधरदलम्. यूनः युवकस्य अधरं कथमस्ति? दत्त दन्त व्रण अङ्कम्. शिस् बिटन् द जम्बुकि, द शी जेकाल् हेस् बिटन् दट् एण्ड् गिवन् अ वूण्ड् व्रणम् एण्ड् इट् इस् अङ्कम् अङ्कितं चिह्नितम् अस्ति. दन्तेन चिह्नितम् अस्ति. तथा नायिकापक्षे अपि दन्तेन चिह्नितम् अस्ति चुम्बनव्यवहारे. तादृशम् अधरदलम् आस्वाद्य आस्वाद्य अनङ्गक्रियायां लग्ना एषा. का? जम्बुकि. अनङ्गक्रिया इत्युक्ते अत्र शवम् अङ्गरहितं कर्तुं तादृशक्रियायां लग्ना अस्ति. सो अनङ्ग अङ्गं यस्य न विद्यते, अङ्गानि यस्य न विद्यते अनङ्ग, तादृश अङ्गराहित्यक्रिया. ओके, वेर् इस् हियर् इट् इस् अनङ्गः मन्मथः. मन्मथक्रीडायां लग्ना नायिका. अतिरभस उत्कर्षम् आविष्करोति. दट् इस् युर् क्रियाविशेषणं, नाट् द रेस्ट्. सो दिस् इस् अतिरभस उत्कर्षं करोति. शी शोस् आफ् एन्थूसियसम् बै डूयिङ्ग् दिस्. ओके, नौ द नेक्स्ट् वन् इस् अ ह्यूज् पेराग्राफ् दट् हि रैस्ट्स् एस् एन् एक्स्प्लेनेशन् फार् दिस्. सो इट्स् गोण्ट् बी द सेम् थिङ्ग् अगेन्. You can see that he doesn't mention the word Naika anywhere in the shloka. That is your clue. So the actually the main rasam, Angi rasam is Bibatsa, Anga rasam is Shringara. They are supposed to be opposing rasas. I told you about the Virodhi rasa, where the first one he mentions is Nyayav Shringara Bibatsa, Tatha Vira Bhayanakav Virodhinaha Mitaha, Vairino Mitaha. So Shringara and Bibatsa are supposed to be Virodhi rasa. even those two Virodhi rasas, he very creatively he is able to put those two together in a shlokam. Okay, I have just taken the text itself because it's such a huge one and it's easier this way. So atra slesha upamaya. Each word has two meanings, so there is slesha, and he has compared it. Upama, I would say, is not direct. Yes, sorry, it is direct. Kshibasya iva. There is just that, just like how kshibasya yunaha yatha bhavati tatha. Only that is mentioned, whereas the nayika pakshi, where the other, there is only one adjective for the yuvaka. The rest of the adjectives are all for Jambuki, without mentioning the nayika. So atra slesha upamaya tulyakaksha adhirudha adhirudayoho api paraspara viruddhayoho tulyakaksha adhirudayoho. Both bibhatsa and shringara are seem to be equal in the shloka. Paraspara viruddhayoho, they are opposing to each other. Even then, bibhatsa shringarasya angangi bhava yojanayam. They are used in the manner in which there is angangi bhava. And jambuki tarunashavasya kshibasya iva nischalasthitehe sahasayeva jambuki hrita hridaya padma akrishtachittava. Now, the first part is for the jambuki, akrishtachitta is for the nayika. So jambuki tarunashavasya kshibasya iva, just like an intoxicated man is there and he looks at a nayika. The nayika is attracted to that man. The way she will behave, that description is also known through the shlesha usages. So hrita hridaya padma akrishta chittava. Hrita hridaya padma, one who has plucked out that hridayam, or akrishta chitta, attracted mind. Kanthe lagna. Next is shonite bhrisham abhivyakta spriha. Shonite rudhire abhivyakta spriha. She has shown her liking towards that shonitam. Rakta abhivyakta kama. Rakta abhivyakta kama. You take it as two different words where you say rakta is anurakta. Abhivyakta kama, the nayika has shown her kama vyavaharam in a vyanjayati. She suggests her idea. Nakha ullekham asutrayanti. Datta danta vranam adharam aswadya aswadya. Angachedak kriyayam. Angachedak kriyayam is ananga kriyayam for the jambuki, whereas for the nayika it is ananga bhoga kriyayam. Va lagna gatranam urdhvagatam karshanam ratha kaushala utkarsham. Atirabhasa utkarsham, I forgot about that. So that atirabhasa is, she keeps, the jambuki keeps pulling it upwards to wherever she is going to stay. So gatranam urdhvagatam karshanam, it doesn't pull it down, but it keeps pulling it out from down. When the corpse is lying down, you can only pull it upwards towards you, right? So the jackal will bow down towards the corpse and keep pulling it upwards. So atirabhasa utkarsham. Utkarsham, he splits it by saying urdhvagatam karshanam for the jambuki, whereas for the nayika, his is ratha kaushala utkarshaha. Utkarshaha is just uttamatvam. So ratyam tasyaha kaushalasya uttamatvam pradarshayati prakashayati iti samanayoho bibhatsa shringarayoho. Both seem equal in all of these, so you won't understand suddenly that the one is angam, the other is angi. Where you understand that the bibhatsa rasam is angi is because kamini pada parityagena. That's very important. He has not used the word kamini or the nayika pada parityagena by leaving out the word of kamini. Kevalam jambukyaha kartrutvena, using only jambuki as the karta. Bibhatsasyaiva pradhanye. Bibhatsarasa is alone the pradhana rasa here. Shringare angatam upagate. Shringara becomes an anga for this. Why? Now he brings in the prakarana. Kshemendra gives that prakarana. He says, Vaktuhu bodhisattvasya. The vakta, the person who says this shloka, is a bodhisattva. ఈజ్ అ ఫాలోవర్ ఆఫ్ బుద్ధ అండ్ హీస్ అ బుద్ధ సన్యాసి. అంతర్గత గాఢ వైరాగ్య వాసనా అధివాసిత చేతస, ది అడ్జెక్టివ్ హీ గివ్స్ ఫర్ ద బోధిసత్వ ఇస్ గాఢ వైరాగ్యం. హీ హ్యాస్ అన్ ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్ డిటాచ్మెంట్ అంతర్గతం దట్ ఈస్ దేర్ విత్ ఇన్ హిమ్. బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్ డిటాచ్మెంట్ దట్ ఈస్ దేర్ విత్ ఇన్ హిమ్, సో దట్ వాసన అధివాసిత చేతస, హిస్ మైండ్ ఈస్ అధివాసితం, ఇస్ ఫిల్డ్ విత్ దట్ వాసన సంస్కారం విచ్ ఆర్ అరిజన్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ దట్ గాఢ వైరాగ్యం ఆర్ డిటాచ్మెంట్ దట్ ఈస్ దేర్ ఇన్ హిస్ మైండ్. కుత్సా కుత్సార్హ జుగుప్సయా, బికాస్ హిస్ మైండ్ హ్యాస్ దట్ డిటాచ్మెంట్ అండ్ హీఈస్ అ బోధిసత్వ, హీ టాక్స్ విత్ అ జుగుప్స డిస్గస్ట్ విచ్ ఇస్ కుత్సా అర్హం, విచ్ హీఈస్ ఆల్సో టాకింగ్ విత్ డిస్గస్ట్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అర్హం మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అప్రోప్రియట్ టు బి రిడిక్యూల్డ్, నాట్ రిడిక్యూల్డ్, రిడిక్యూల్డ్ ఇస్ అ వెరీ సాఫ్ట్ టర్మ్ హియర్, కుత్సా ఇస్ నిందార్హం, హ్యాస్ టు బి అబ్యూస్డ్ లిటరలీ లైక్ దట్, దట్స్ వాట్ హీ ఫీల్స్. నితంబిని రతి విడంబనం, ద యూనియన్ బిట్వీన్ విమెన్, దట్ విడంబనం he is ridiculing that union that is there, that the enjoyment that he had before or what people are experiencing in this world, he is jugupsa yuktena nindati saha ratim, so that is why it is auchitya ruchiratam adadati, because he is a sannyasi and he has to look upon the enjoyments vishaya anubhuti with garha or jugupsa. He says this, he says it is parama auchityam, that is why there is a great propriety in this. Yadyapi atra mahavakye shantasya eva pradhanyam, mahavakye, mahavakye means the entire text in the entire kavyam of Baudha Vadana Kalpalata, there shantasya eva pradhanyam, it is a shantapradhana kavyam. తథాపి అస్మిన్ ఉదాహరణ శ్లోకే బీభత్సస్యైవ ప్రాధాన్యం వర్తతే, శృంగారస్య తు అంగభావం అస్తి, బీభత్సరసస్య అంగిభావం అస్మిన్ శ్లోకే వర్తతే, కింతు సంపూర్ణే కావ్యే శాంతస్యైవ ప్రాధాన్యం వర్తతే. సో దట్ డస్ నాట్ ఫిగర్ హియర్ ఇన్ దిస్, వి విల్ టేక్ ఇట్ అస్ ఓన్లీ బీభత్స ఇస్ ది అంగం అండ్ ద శృంగార ఇస్ ది, సారీ, బీభత్స ఇస్ ది అంగి అండ్ శృంగారం ఇస్ ది అంగం. చలో
ஓகே, ஸோ இந்த கான்டெக்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தி ஸ்லோகா வந்து நிஜமாவே ஒரு நரி வந்து ஒரு சவத்தை எடுத்துட்டு இருக்க, அண்ட் ஒரு புத்திஸ்ட் மாங்க் இஸ்
வியூயிங் தட் சீன்
அண்ட் கமெண்ட் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்காரு, பட் அவரோட அந்த இன்டென்டே வந்து இத அந்த என்ன சொல்றது விடம் நிதம்பி நீரத்தி விடம்பனம் தான். ஸோ பக்திரு வைசிஷ்டியத்தினால நம்ம அந்த ரெண்டாவது காமினி அர்த்தத்தை எடுத்துட்டு ஆனோம்.
Yes, you need that Kamini Artham just to show that Shringara Rasam has been used as an Anga. Iliya? Bhaktra Vaishishtyam Venume? Puri Lenke? What's your doubt?
Yeah, no, if Kamini is not mentioned anywhere, then how does Shringara Rasa even come into place?
Because of the play of the words that he uses, Dhruta Hrita Hridaya, the slesha enables us to understand that kamini meaning there. See, ananga kriya is there, that ananga kriya nobody will immediately, if you only look at that ananga kriya, because of the vasana that we have, because of the so many kavyams that we have read or so many alankara shastras that we have seen, ananga kriya will immediately only give rise to manmatha kriya in our mind.
Oh.
We will okay. Never even think that it is anga rahitya karanam.
ஜம்புகி பக்ஷம் புரியறது கொஞ்சம்
கஷ்டப்பட்டேன்.
That shloka that we had in the beginning where he quoted for Anauchityan, that Bilanveshi Sarpaha Pravishati, that same thing for the Shijakal, he had one quoted, right?
Correct.
This is very similar to that, but how is this Auchityam, is I am not able to understand, because when he said that Jambuki, When he mentions Jambuki itself, we are like, you know, Bibatsam is there. How can we, even with the play of Shringaram, does it not resonate anauchityam here? How is this auchityam?
No, here it is the rasa sankarasya auchityam. There is an equal emphasis given for both Shringaram and Bibatsam, with Bibatsam as the angarasa. It is not Shringara as the angarasa. Which shloka are you talking about? Just tell me. I think it is that
Bilanveshi sarpaha that hata gaja kara ka, hata gaja.
I know what you're saying. I just wanted to look at that shloka.
I forgot the beginning. That is the last two lines. That is
in the context of.
In the context of, I think it is one of the rasas only. I think Shringara rasasya anauchityam va. I think Shringarasi Anauchityam.
Alankara after Alankara Uchityam.
Or is it
Shringarasi Uchityam?
No, not Shringarasi. I think it is in the beginning, Akka, first. Padagatam.
Must be the Padam or.
Padagatam,
something.
Yeah, Padagatam. That shloka, right? Where.
It is very similar to that shloka, but he mentions Rathikhinna Iva Vanita, correct? So that Vanita is mentioned there. Vanita, then every word goes to that. It's actually an Alankara Anauchityam.
But if you know the context, what is this Chandraka Kavi's context? Inge vandu his intent is to other entity compare panni, other ridicule pandrathu dhaan avaroda. So it's fine. But...
Because it is the author's own work, he is able to present the context to us in a better manner. Whereas the Chandraka's poem, we don't know the context there. Yeah.
Oh.
Mm. So, kasyachit ranaanganasya varnanam tatra. Ranaangane, what is the necessity for a Vanita varnanam there?
Yeah. Yeah, there anauchityam is very, you know, we are able to identify the anauchityam there. Here, when he's mixing Bibhatsam and Shringaram, how is he able to bring out auchityam? That I'm not able to understand.
So, the auchityam lies in the fact you have to have the context in mind. So, what is the context here? It is the bodhisattva or a sannyasi who is there. A Buddha sannyasi is the person who is talking about this. He is looking at a scene. He is looking at the corpse of a young man. His idea is always to feel detached from the world. The moment he looks at a jambuki, which is just plucking the entrails of that corpse, the pradhanatvam is bibatsam there. Even though Shantarasam is the pradhanam for the entire kavyam, the Shantarasam, there can be angarasas everywhere. So, Bibatsam can be an angarasa for Shanta. That is, that you can accept, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, in this particular shloka, Bibatsam is what is important. And by trying to highlight that Bibatsa, he uses, you know, he uses that Shringaram and highlights by saying, you know, I am not interested in Shringara at all. It is very equal to this Bibatsam for me.
Oh, okay. So it is more of what the Bodhisattva feels.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So that is why it is Vaktra Vaishishtyam. That is what Kamakshi was trying to point out. She said Vaktra Vaishishtyam is very important in the sense Vakta, who is the person who is saying it? What is there in his mind, which is the guard, antargata gadha vairagya vasana adivasita chetaha.
Oh, okay. Yeah, got it.
That is why he is able to express it in this manner. See, even anyone else may probably look at it. I am looking at both the Shringaram and Shringara scene also like this scene. Those two are equal to me. That is what the Bodhisattva feels in his mind.
Yeah.
So some might look at it as Shringaram, even though, you know, just as I said, the moment we read the shloka, to bring in the Jambuki context itself was difficult for us. The Ananga Kriya immediately showed us only Shringara imagery in our mind rather than the Bibatsa imagery.
Yeah.
After understanding the meaning of how it fits with the Jambuki, then you get the Bibatsam slowly. Oh, okay. If the man was alive, then you look at it with Shringaram. If the man is dead, then Bharyabhipyati tasmin kaye.
Yeah.
Na yavat pavano nivasati dehe, tavat prichhati kushalam gehe. How are you? People will ask you. Vayo deha apaye, Bharyabhipyati tasmin kaye. A woman who has been with that man, she fears that body. That is the idea that he wants to bring out at the end of it.
Correct.
Now, Vibhatsam goes hand in hand in Shringara only if the Vakta can be a sannyasi. Otherwise, it will never fit anybody else. It should not. People who are in this enjoyment and who are not a sannyasi, who are still in this world, can never look at both with Vibhatsam. It's tough for them to, unless they also have that Gaadha Vairagyam. But my professor would say, you can't look at Shringaram with Bibhatsam, it doesn't fit. You have to learn to, appreciate that also. You can reject it. You don't need to feel disgusted about it. Disgust is a too extreme a feeling, he would say. I think that's where the Sahrudaya Vasana plays. Okay. The next one is Veera Karunayoho Auchityam. Yatha mama muni mata mimamsayam. This is, I think, the same context as that Abhimanyu's death, where Subhadra was talking, and I think she was moaning about the death, and the horses were, listening to her words. This is very similar to that. Here, he's talking of Arjuna's feeling at Abhimanyu's death. Gandiva Sruva Marjana Pranayinaha Snatasya Bashpambubihi Chandam Kandava Pavakadapi Param Shokanalam Bibhrataha Jishnoho Nutana Yovvanodaya Dinat Chinna Abhimanyoho Chiram Havatsa Iti You have to, for Arjuna, you can't show his Karunarasam like how Subhadra was, Subhadrayaha vilapaiva Arjunasya vilapaha iti vaktum na shakyate. We have to show that veerattvam there. So it's a beautiful combination of veerarasam and Karunarasam here. So the adjectives he gives for Arjuna is Gandiva Sruva Marjana Pranayinaha. He's ready to take revenge on Saindhava. Saindhava vadhe vadhaya arabdhaha abhichara japaha. If you want to kill someone, you use abhichara prayogam, which is called black magic, which is also given in Atharva Veda. And that is called abhichara prayogam. Abhicharaha is a yagam or a process or a puja that is done with an intent to take revenge or kill your enemy. Abhichare japaha chiram babhuva kasya jishnoho arjunasya saindhava vadhaya arabdhaha japaha chiram babhuva. What was the japam that he was continuously saying? Havatsa. Oh, my child, that 16-year-old child is dead, and he is using that karunam as a japam for taking revenge on Saindhava Jayadratha. Sindhu Rajaha Saha Jayadratha. So Saindhava Vadha Jayadratasya Vadhasya Krite Arabdhaha Japaha. The adjectives he gives for Arjuna, Gandiva Sruva Marjana Pranayinaha. He loves to clean his Gandivam. And that Gandivam is Sruva. Sruva, there are a lot of these, when you're doing a yagam, there are different ladles for different things. So Sruva is a type of ladle. So he's generally polishing all these things. He has to start the yagam of Saindhava Vadham. For that, the samagri that he needs are first, he has to clean up all the vessels that are there necessary for that. That is his Gandivam here. So Gandiva Marjane Pranayaha Vartate Tasya. अर्जुनस्य. सो गाण्डीव एव स्रुव विच् इस् द याग लाडल् एण्ड् तस्य मार्जन प्रणयिनः, मार्जनस्य प्रणयि, हि लव्स् टु क्लीन् दट् गाण्डीवं. सो इमेजिन् हि इस् क्लीनिङ्ग् हिस् गाण्डीवम् एण्ड् हि इस् थिङ्किङ्ग् अबौट् हिस् शोकम् एण्ड् हि इस् सेङ्ग् हा वत्स जो कोळन्द पेटिये अप्डिना. I can even picture the way he must be thinking of that revenge, and at the same time his karunam is there in the mind. Next is, you, before the yagam you have to do a snana diksha. Snanam kartavyam. So what is the snanam that he does here? Bashpa ambubihi snatasya. He has taken a bath with his tears. Bashpa ambubihi, with the waters he is bathed with tears. Next is Agni. For a yagam you need Agni. What is the Agni here? Shokanala. Kandava pavakadapi param chandam shokanala. He destroyed that Kandava vana for Indraprastham. For that destruction he used pavakam, Agni. This Agni that is there in his mind, the shokanala, the grief, the fire of sorrow that is there in his mind is more terrible than that Kandava fire, Kandava Agni. काण्डव अरण्यं नाशयितुं यः अग्निः उपयुक्तः, दिस् शोकाग्नि इस् मोर् प्रचण्डः. द नेक्स्ट् वन् इस् नूतन यौवन उदय दिन छिन्न अभिमन्योः. हि इस् द एड्जेक्टिव् हि गिव्स् हियर् इस् यो पाप अभिमन्यु. The Chinna Abhimanyu, one Abhimanyu has been cut here, right? He was killed on the day, on Dinam, where he had freshly attained youth. That 16 years is a very young age to die. Now, so Nudana Yavvana Udaya Dine Yaha Chinnaha Saha Abhimanyuhu. Yasya Abhimanyuhu. So Yasya Abhimanyuhu Chinnaha Tadrishaha Jishnuhu. Arjunaha. So Arjunasya, so whose son Abhimanyu was killed on the day that he attained his youth freshly. So for a vrata, how you start before killing? That was this japa. So Jishnoho Tadrisha Arjunasya Havatsa Iti Saindhava Vadha Arabdha Abhichare Abhichare Japaha Chiram Babuva. Atra Trigartha Sangramagatasya. Trigartha is a kingdom. So there were many kingdoms during Mahabharata time. And Trigartha was maybe in today's time, it was Pakistan or somewhere there, where all the three rivers, you know, that Satluj, Shatadruma, Satluj, Ravi and Bias. I forgot the Sanskrit names. I think one is Iravati, the other I don't remember. So those three rivers formed together to form this Gartam. Gartam is a the three rivers are surrounding that place, and that kingdom is called Trigartam. That is where Jayadratha was supposed to be, and Arjuna went there to kill him. So Trigartha Sangrama Gatasya Gandiva Dhanmanaha Arjunasya Shatrubihi Nava Yavvana Nihata Tanayasya. Shatrubihi, by his enemies, his son was killed at that point of time. Karmuka Sruvam Unmarjayataha. He is cleaning his bow, which is the Sruva, which is that ladle. And Prasarat Ashru Snatasya. Ashru, tears are continuously falling from him. And he has bathed himself with that shokagni udvahataha. He is bearing that shokagni, that fire of sorrow. Ha putra iti chiram jayadrata vadha arabdha avichare japaha babhuva iti yatu upanyastam. That which has been said in the shloka, tena arikshaye. Now this is karunarasam, the first part. Now he is explaining the veera rasam, how the veera rasa is the angi or the pradhanam here. Arikshaye, while destroying the enemies, diksha samuchita vratam. So the diksha, the vratam actually has to have, you have to take a diksha for that. He is explaining that varnana is also here. And shokagnehe chandatvena, the shokagni is more powerful than kandava pada udiranena. by highlighting that Kandava Vana destruction and saying that the Shokagni is more prachanda than that, more terrible than that. Veera rasasya anginaha sahasa eva agantuke karuna rase prachalite. That karuna rasa actually kindles this veera rasa more. Because he ends with that abhichare japaha chiram abhut babuva. Correct? Saindava vada arabdha abhichara abhidanena paryante shaurya nirvahena param auchityam ujrambate. So he highlights that auchitya for that angirasam very greatly. Right? Yeah. I think we'll have to stop with this. Time is up. Every shloka in this are all big, big shlokas with four lines. The next one is he combines Shringara, Karuna, and Bibatsa in it. Shanta, Shringara, and Bibatsa in that. So it is also another big shloka. So we will stop with this.
Sahasaiva agantuke karuna rase abrina nartham.
Sahasaiva agantuke karuna rase veera rasasya. Okay. So. அது எப்படி சொல்றதுன்னா
ஜஸ்ட் அந்த ஆகந்துக்கான எனக்கு
ஆகந்துக்கம்னா வருகைன்னு அர்த்தம் அதிதி பூதம் சோ த கருணரச இஸ் லைக் an அதிதி இட் இஸ் லைக் a கெஸ்ட் which just increases that it is not that Arjuna did not have veera rasa before that he did have veera rasa he was killing but now suddenly this agantukam karunarasam means the with the death of abhimanyu that rasa has come like an atithi and it is rekindled that veerasa
so munnadi veerarasasya enna solradhu
prasangaha vartate veerarasa pradhanam adanalana veerarasasya angi anginaha veerarasasya agantuke karunarasa karunarase illaya கருணரசே பிரஜ்வலித்தே when that karuna rasa just enters at that point of time it just increases that veera rasa அதனால தான் ஆகந்துக்கம்னு போடுறாரு ஓ கரெக்ட் ஐ டிட் நோட் தட் சோ பரமம் ஔசித்யம் உஜ்ஜிரம்பதே தி எக்ஸாம்பிள்ஸ் ஹி டேக்ஸ் ஆர் பியூட்டிஃபுல் சரி we'll stop with this okay
அவரோட சொந்த காவியத்தை அவர் ரொம்ப நல்லா ரசிச்சிருக்கார்
உடனே படிக்கணும்னு
Namaste, Akka.